Speak Indo Podcast is a medium to think about life while learning about the Indonesian language and culture. Hi, I'm Natasha, the host of Speak Indo Podcast. The first part of the story will be narrated in the Indonesian language. The second part will be in English. The transcript is available on our blog, speakindo.life, and our YouTube, Speak Indo channel. Season 3, Episode A4, A Bigger Tummy. Tahun pertama kuliah di Amerika, gue tinggal di asrama. Pertama kali makan di asrama, kaget sekali, karena selain jumlahnya banyak, juga ukurannya besar-besar. Formatnya adalah makan sepuasnya. Dari makanan pembuka, makanan utama dan penutup. Bahkan ada ice cream tiap hari tersedia. Jenis roti juga bermacam-macam. Ada donat dengan rasa keju, maple syrup, coklat dan gula halus. Semuanya gue suka. Tiap hari, gue makan 3 kali sehari dan selalu makan donat. Di tahun 90-an, belum terlalu banyak pilihan untuk beli donat di Indonesia. Setahun di Amerika, berat gue naik 10 kilo. Ukuran baju pun bertambah. Saat pulang ke Indonesia, banyak yang kaget melihat gue. Dan gue pun kaget melihat satu porsi bakmi ayam yang dulu rasanya cukup banyak, sekarang seperti ukuran anak-anak. Akhirnya, porsi satu pun tidak cukup. Minimum 2, dengan tambahan pangsit goreng. Abang bakmi langganan gua pun senang. The next one will be the English version of the story. I lived in the dormitory during my first year in college in America. The first time I ate in the dormitory, I was very surprised, as there was a lot of food in huge portions. The format was all you can eat, from appetizers, main course, and dessert. Even ice cream was available every day. There were many different types of bread. There were donuts with different toppings, cheese, maple syrup, chocolate, and icing sugar. I liked all of them. Every day, I ate 3 times a day and always had donuts. In the 90s era, there were not many options to buy donuts in Indonesia. 1 year living in America, I gained 10 kilos and my dress size also went up. When I went back to Indonesia, many were shocked to see me. I was surprised when the usual portion of chicken noodles that I used to feel was quite a lot, now feels like a kid's portion. At the end, one portion was not enough. I had to have at least 2 with fried wontons on the side. This made the noodle seller quite happy. As this is one of our editions, as we are still in the midst of the COVID-19 pandemic, we'd like to extend our deep condolences to those who have lost their loved ones. This is definitely a very difficult time for everyone, and we can only hope that soon we can all heal as nature flourishes. Probably one day when we look back, we learn that how valuable is the time that we have to hug our loved ones, to be kind to our fellow humans, and to thank the sun for shining upon us. I'm Natasha, your host of Speak Indo Podcast, and we would like to thank our guest speakers for sharing their story. If you like the story, please share it with your friends and family. The transcript of the story is available at our blog speakindo.life and our YouTube Speak Indo channel. You can subscribe to our channel so that you won't miss any upcoming episodes. These are our stories. What is yours?